In this video, you're going to learn how to set up the API connection in Bubble for DALL-3 through OpenAI. This is a free preview of our full image generation tutorial, our no-code MBA, where we'll go through from start to finish how to build an image generation app using DALL-3, Stable Diffusion XL, as well as image to image through Stable Diffusion. So I hope you enjoy this video and check out the link below if you want to go to the full course and build out the full project. I hope this is helpful. If you have any questions, just leave a comment below. In this video, you're going to build an image generation app using DALL-3 through OpenAI. So first, we need to make sure that we have our API connector set correctly in Bubble. So in our Bubble app, we're going to go to our plugins. If you don't have your API connector set up already, you'll add that as a plugin and then add your API connector. And then you're going to set up your OpenAI API connection. Now, the first part you can keep from your other tutorials that you've gone through where we've set up our OpenAI connection. But if you haven't yet, just set up an API as OpenAI. This is just an internal name for our app. Then private key and header. Then authorization, and then the word bearer, and then a space, and then your API key, and then copy and paste the same thing into the development key. And we're in the development app right now. The live app is if you would publish your app and go live. But right now, the development key is what we're using. So just copy and paste both to be the same. And then what we're gonna do is go down and add an API call. So go ahead and click add an API call. I'm going to name it, image generation. And then what I'm going to do is go into the OpenAI API documentation and show you how to read that documentation to add our image generation API call. So you need to go to platform.openai.com and then go to the API reference. You can also search API reference OpenAI and Google should get you here as well. And we need to go down to the images endpoint. So the images endpoint is what we're going to use to actually generate an image through OpenAI. So we're going to go down to create image, which is the API call that we're going to use to actually generate our image. So first we can see that it is a post API call. So we're going to change it from get to post. Post means that we're sending information to OpenAI. We're going to get back information from them with a response. We're going to copy that URL there and just paste the URL right next to it. We're also going to use it as an action because we want to be able to use this API call in our workflow, and you'll see how we do this a little bit later. And then what we're going to do is check the headers. So the first header, authorization bearer OpenAI key, we already set that up in our API call, which is shared throughout all of our API calls here from OpenAI, but we do need to add content type application JSON. So I'm just going to add a header, paste that in. It's best to paste it in because if there's any caps differences, capitalization differences, or any typos, it will not work. So I'm going to go ahead and paste in application JSON. And then if we look at this dash D, this is the body here that we're going to add in. And we're going to just copy from the curly brackets to the curly brackets. So we're leaving everything inside of those quotes. We want to paste in here. Oh, whoops, because I didn't copy it correctly. So just copy it and then paste that in here. Okay, so DALL-3, this is the model that we're using. This is the newest model from OpenAI currently, but in the future, everything should likely stay the same, but you might just have DALL-4 that you're using as the model. The prompt, this is what we're going to dynamically change. N equals 1 means we're going to get one response, but we can change that between 1 and 10. For DALL-3 right now, only N equals 1 is supported. So that's why it's good to read the documentation. Sometimes this could change. I'll show you the models. So if we go down to the models, there are different models that you could be using, such as DALL-3. This is an API call to see the available models, just as an example, but we can also see them in the playground. But in our case, we're going to be using DALL-3, so we're just going to do N equals 1 for one response here. And then the size, so the size of the generated images, and you can see it must be one of these three sizes. There's other image generation models, such as Stable Diffusion, that might allow you to do different sizes. So just know that there's other options, but here, this API is currently saying it needs to be one of these three sizes, and of course that could also change in the future. There's other things that we could add if we want, but I'm going to leave them blank and only have these four parameters here. Okay, so this is the default. So let me initialize the call and just initialize it real quick with their default acute baby sea otter, and let's see what image is generated for us here. Okay, so here we go, and it gave us a URL here. I'm going to see the raw data. So the first thing that it did, which is pretty cool, is you can see that part of what makes DALL-E 3 powerful is it's automatically revising your prompt and making it more detailed. So one thing with image generation in general is the better the prompt, the better the result. So what I'm going to do is just take this URL, I'm going to copy it, and then let's just paste it in here in a new tab, and we're going to see the image that was generated. Okay, awesome. So we got a really cool image that was generated here by OpenAI, DALL-E 3. So we have to click save to initialize our call fully. And now we could use it in a workflow in Bubble, but what we need to do first is make it so we can dynamically change this prompt, because we want users to be able to enter a prompt and then get a result back. So to do this, we just have to add these dynamic values here. The left and right. So we're going to do this just including the quotes, and we're going to have the quotes be a part of our dynamic value. So I'm just going to name it prompt, and then if you click away, we're going to get this key value here. And let's say we want to now create an image of a cute baby panda. And then let's uncheck private because we want to be able to see this in the workflow, and you'll see in a minute why this is important. And we will reinitialize the call. And oh, sorry, I forgot to add the quotations. So again, add the quotations here in the prompt. And now let's initialize the call. And just give it a second here to generate. And here we are, we got a response. So I'm going to show the raw data. And here we go, we got a revised prompt here, which is kind of interesting to see. And I'm going to go ahead and paste this image in. And there we go. All right, cool. So a really high quality image. It's pretty amazing what you can create with DALL-E 3 and these APIs. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and click save here. And what we're going to do now is build an app, a page in an app that is going to allow users to enter in their own prompt, and then you're going to be able to see the result that is generated here all in an app. Thanks for watching this video. If you want to watch the full project and complete the full tutorial, which includes building a full image generation app using DALL-E, Stable Diffusion, and an image-to-image generation app using Stable Diffusion, check the link below and go to our Building Apps with AI course on No-Code MBA. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below, and be sure to subscribe to our channel to get all of our free content in the future here on YouTube.